Hi, hello, namaste. In this short section, we'll be discussing about the properties of curl and we'll be seeing the operator of curl on different coordinate systems. So here are the few of the properties of the curl. The first property states curl of a vector is a vector quantity, means to say curl of some vector p will always be getting me another vector quantity. Okay, the second property, curl of a vector a plus vector b, the curl will be getting distributed across the both the things, so it is curl of a plus curl of b. So it's a straightforward property. The third property is curl of a, or you can tell of curl of a, that vector is again taken as a curl. So that can be simply solved using this particular formula, where it is nothing but del of divergence of A minus del square A. So the fourth property states divergence of a curl is zero, means to say divergence of a curl is always equal to zero. If I want to be more specific in making this understandable, curl is always a rotational field, right? You have a magnetic field rotating around some point where the current is flowing. If I say this is the current that is coming out, so it is not coming out according to my direction, it is going in. So if the current is flowing in and this is the direction of my flux that is revolving around this particular conductor, and if I want to know the divergence of this field, how the field is getting diverged out, it is nowhere diverging at all. So divergence is not possible in the magnetic field. It will not get diverged. It is a closed path, right? So there is no concept of divergence. So it's zero. Coming to the fifth property, the curl of a scalar value has no sense. Means to say, if I have a curl of a scalar quantity, so this is a scalar quantity, it has no sense. There is no meaning for this. Okay, I can't define this. And the sixth point, the curl of the gradient of a scalar is zero. So the curl of a gradient of a scalar quantity, let me say some V is a scalar quantity, so it is gradient, the curl of this gradient is always equal to zero. Fine. And lastly, I have curl of vector A cross vector B, whereas A and B are cross product. To solve such problems, I can take vector A times divergence of B minus vector B times divergence of A plus B dot my divergence operator times vector A plus vector A dot divergence operator the whole times B. So this is one more property, and there are much more properties like this, but for our point of interest, these are the main properties that we need to concentrate upon. Coming to the curl operator on different coordinate systems, so if you see, this is what we had derived in our topic of curl, where del cross A or del of curl, curl of A vector was solved using the matrix. You no need to remember or memorize this whole thing, so it is not needed. Okay, just you need to know the actual matrix. So if you know this matrix, you can get to this. It is just a simple matrix solution. So AX, AY, AZ are the coordinate systems. This is my del operator, this corresponds to del, and this corresponds to my vector A. So solving for this whole matrix will be getting me this particular expression, so which we have already done. So similarly, for a cylindrical coordinate system, I should be solving this matrix to get my cylindrical coordinate system's solution. So the curl of A in cylindrical coordinate system, as we already know, it is A rho, rho A phi and A z times. This is my del operator and this is my A vector in the cylindrical coordinate systems. Okay, For solving this particular matrix, I'll be getting the curl of A in cylindrical coordinate systems. Finally, for a spherical coordinate system, again, as already said, this whole matrix is enough to get my spherical coordinate systems curl of A. So I specifically say that you don't need to mug up or memorize or remember this whole equations. It's just the basic that you have to have in mind. So what are the coordinate systems? If this is a coordinate, what are the components of the vectors, and what are the operators that I have to use? If you know this particular things, you can easily get the final expression that we need to apply in problems. So this is the basics of curl operator and the curl operator in different coordinate systems. Hope this is a very straightforward concept, which there is nothing much of thought to be placed. And one more thing, the curl concept of curl, if I want to say, if I have a current coming out of a surface, this is how my magnetic field will be rotating. I'm just trying to make you people understand, and this is the magnetic field intensity or magnetic field which is revolving around it. So I can apply the curl operator for this, so I'll be getting some quantity. If I say I'm finding the magnetic field intensity at some point where my some force of lines are something like this, so there if you apply the curl, curl is not an operator over here. It can't give you anything because there is no rotational force over it here. It is just a force which is moving in straight lines. So curl can be only applied to a point where you have a closed path and it is a rotational force. Here you don't have a closed path. It is just flowing out. So in this type of situations, we had applied in electrostatics divergence. Okay, divergence holds good here, but divergence doesn't hold good here. So keep those concepts in mind. This is not possible here, like which is not possible here. So that's it for this video, guys. Thank you. See ya.